A resurgence for Jefferson Riverport International.
Companies are setting up shop at the industrial park, investing millions in hiring hundreds of employees. WLKY Steve Bergen joins us live with what makes the park so attractive to new businesses. Steve?
Rick, Vicki, the Riverport is an economic jewel in an often forgotten section of southwest Jefferson County. Not only has it created jobs, the industrial park has brought about new growth in that area.
Local companies, national companies, international companies.
It was an idea hatched in the mid-60s. Today it's a sprawling commercial development. More than 2,000 acres featuring 13 million square feet of space. And the type of companies run the gambit. 112 at last count.
Before Riverport got going here, there weren't any jobs in this part of the community.
There are homegrown businesses and those with names recognized around the world. Some provide parts for bigger companies like Toyota and Ford. Gazelle is the newest to land here.
Revolutionizing the way we buy, use, and then sell and recycle mobile devices.
The Boston-based company plans to invest millions and eventually hire more than 400 people.
To think of the confidence that this company has in this community, to invest that kind of money.
Riverport President Larry McFall says there's one major reason Gazelle and other companies are locating here, the UPS World Port.
I tell everybody that UPS will have a bigger impact on Louisville, Kentucky in this century than the railroads did in the last century and the river did in the century before that.
State and local governments offer financial incentives, and the fact Riverport is designated a foreign trade zone means more economic advantages. McFall says Riverport serves as a barometer on what the future holds for the nation's economy. When the phone stops ringing, he knows a slowdown is ahead.
And similarly, when the economy starts improving, our phone starts ringing. Our phone's ringing right now.
Right now, 6,500 people work at the Riverport. Coming up at 11, you'll hear from the CEO of a company that recently moved its headquarters to Louisville from the San Francisco Bay Area. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.